Philippine Election Commission takes control of two more areas with a recent history of election-related violence. COMELEC Chairman Sidomen Pangarungan identified these as Misamis Occidental and the town of Pilar in Abra. Pilar was earlier tagged as an area of concern after the security detail of re-electionist Vice Mayor Jaja Disono had a deadly shootout with local police in March. The town's entire police force was replaced following the incident.
Confidential reports disclosing the apparent bias ng local police detachment sa Pilar Abra, and also yung mga threats and intimidation to some supporters of certain candidates. With this revelation, I invoke my emergency power.
Tandem of Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo and Senator Francis Pangilinan, endorsed by over 1,000 members of the Catholic clergy just days before the elections. The group, which is comprised of Catholic bishops, priests, and deacons, believes Robredo and Pangilinan are servant leaders with compassion for others. It also cited their clean public service records.
Dubhang kailangan ang mas konkretong pakikilahok ng simbahan sapagkat ito ay labanan sa panig ng totoo at ng buwad. Sa panig ng paglilingkod bayan at ng hangaring paglingkuran ang bayan ng mga pinunong inunuklok sa pwesto ng kapangyarihan.
Ang simbahang Katolika hindi na nagpaalipin sa tinatanong non-partisanship sa mga eleksyon. Matagal na yan dapat nawala, at for the first time after EDSA, ito ang sumusunod. At yan, palagay ko, ay napakagandang development ng ating election kung itong taon na ito.
The support of Catholic Church leaders for Robredo and Pangilinan came a day after the Iglesia ni Cristo announced its support for their rivals, the tandem of Senator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. and Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio. One sociologist says the endorsement may have a political and economic bearing for the religious group.
Being allied with a politician, somebody in power, can protect their own interests as well, especially with respect to land and property and so forth. Now, we don't only see it as a political alliance building, but also as an assertion of its presence in Philippine society. Certainly, there's politics to it. Certainly, there's economics to it. But certainly, also, there's a religious dimension to it, you know, attracting more people who will join.
Former Philippine Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre breaks his silence on accusations he pressured a witness into testifying on the alleged drug links of detained Senator Laila De Lima. In a statement, Aguirre said he was never involved in the alleged coercion of former Bureau of Corrections official Rafael Ragos. Ragos had retracted his earlier testimony about witnessing the delivery of drug money to De Lima. But Aguirre questioned the timing of the retraction. He claims Ragos is being used by the camp of De Lima to boost her election bid.
Senator De Lima pushes back against former Justice Secretary Aguirre's claim the retractions of witnesses against her were related to the upcoming elections. In an interview with ABS-CBN News inside the PNP Custodial Center in Camp Crame on Wednesday, the detained opposition senator said that more than her re-election bid, she is most interested in clearing her name. De Lima is accused of conspiracy to commit illegal drug trading inside the new Bilibid prison. She said she wants vindication in her lifetime, especially with the state of her family. Her ailing 89-year-old mother has been bedridden for the past 3 years and recently survived a bout with COVID. De Lima also rejects allegations she coerced witnesses to retract their statements, saying she doesn't have the capacity to do so given her current situation. She has been detained since 2017. Self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa last week recanted all his allegations, including paying 8 million pesos to De Lima. Meanwhile, former prisons official Rafael Ragos said it was not true he delivered 10 million pesos to De Lima's house in 2012. De Lima says she's also wondering why the witnesses are only recanting their allegations now. She says she expected Ragos to retract much earlier because of inconsistencies in his testimony and his demeanor in court. De Lima now challenging Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara to find out the truth. Beyond Aguirre, De Lima says that ultimately, the one behind the cases against her is President Rodrigo Duterte. Prior to her arrest, Duterte had publicly told De Lima, a vocal critic who initiated a probe into his drug war, that he will destroy her. Malacanang confident the country's gaming regulator will be able to find new sources of revenue following the shutdown of Isabong operations. The closure is expected to cause revenue loss of up to 6 billion pesos for this year. Despite this, President Rodrigo Duterte said the negative social impact prompted him to ban online cockfighting. Apart from the physical establishments, Senator Francis Tolentino wants the Philippine Central Bank to order the removal of the online sabong feature from existing e-wallet applications to avoid a possible underground resurgence of the controversial game. Bagot, however, is not discounting the possibility of its comeback.
I think pwede naman po mangyari yun, especially in a few months, magkakaroon tayo ng bagong leadership. But siyempre kung babalik man po yan, totally hindi na siya tulad nitong ano yung setup ngayon. Definitely talaga dapat kung i-re-propose yan as a source of revenue, dapat lahat ng mga nakita natin na mga naging impact sa society natin, makorek na dapat.